Hey guys, welcome to the fourth and last part of my ASCII RPG tutorial. If you missed the first three parts and my challenge video, you should check them out. Okay, so far we've made the main menu, the saving, the idle screen, the map and the movement, the fight and the healing. In this part we'll make three similar things, the shop, the mayor and the boss. Let's go! First let's make three booleans, which are the buy for the shop, the speak for the mayor and the boss for the boss, obviously. These are false by default. If we go now into our play loop, we can include one more input. For that we will check if the map tile we're on is either the shop, the mayor or the cave. If it is, we print the enter prompt. Now let's code the input action. If you're on the shop tile, then the buy will be true. Same goes for the mayor with the speak bool and for the cave with the boss bool. Now we can make the shop function. The layout is very similar to what we already covered. We invite the buy, the gold, the potion, the elixir and the attack damage here. So while the buy is true, we should show the shop. Take your time to create the shop or just copy mine. Then we ask for the choice input again and code the four outcomes. To buy stuff, it's required to have as much gold as the price of the item at least. Then we can increase the potion number with 1 and don't forget to withdraw the price from the gold. We can tell the player if the purchase is successful or not. We use the same method for the elixir and the upgrade as well, so you can copy paste it and change the values. Now we should include the shop in the play loop. And just to avoid annoying attacks while we test the game, I disable this function for now. Let's win the lottery and go shopping. Potions working, elixirs working and upgrades working. Cool. Now let's go for our NPC, the mayor. He will give us the boss key if we are strong enough. We will use the speak and key booleans here, then we put the casual stuff into the loop. And his speech will depend on our attack damage. If it's below 10, he tells us to practice more. Otherwise, he says we can fight the dragon now and gives us the boss key. Then we should leave an input here too, just so we can leave his place. Now we can call this function in the play loop and check out the game. Yeah, we're not strong enough yet, that's what we expected. But if we go to the shop and buy upgrades, then we go to the mayor again and we are suddenly capable for the fight, so this part is done as well. And the last thing for this series is the boss fight. Let's make the key function for that. We include the boss and the key booleans here. So while the boss is true, we print some stuff to the screen. If we have the key, we should show the first prompt, which is to engage into the fight. The input options are really simple. If we type 2, we simply leave like in the other two functions. But if we type 1 and we have the key, we go and fight the boss. And we almost forget to include the fight bool here, otherwise the fight loop would not happen. Speaking of fight loop, let's include the boss in the battle function. We should only select an enemy from the list if the boss bool is false, otherwise we fight the dragon. Then at the end we can congratulate the player if the boss is defeated. Alright, now let's go for a final check. We can't go into the cave yet, obviously. But with our piles of gold, we go to the shop and buy all necessary stuff. We're beefy enough now, so we can get the key from the mayor. Then we can finally meet the one and only dragon of the game. Let's beat it! Okay, that was easy. I mean, of course, this was kinda cheating, but yeah, we have a complete game now. I know it can be speedrunned in like 5 minutes, but it's something. If you watched until the end, thanks a lot for your time. I'm waiting for your submissions until the 6th day of March. Also, if you have any feedback, you can tell me in the comments. And if you like this series, be sure to subscribe, there will be more stuff like this. Thanks again and see you soon. Stay safe and take care.